Pakistan's largest province, Balochistan, may not mean much to many people. But among the experts, it's known as a sectarian terrorism hotbed. And some U.S. lawmakers are even calling for its independence. RT's Gainetcha Chikan explains the region and its importance.
Balochistan. You may have never heard of it, or maybe caught a glimpse of it in a Hollywood blockbuster, but the place is a hot destination for intelligence services from around the globe. Hotbed of insurgency, home to various terrorist organizations. Kidnappings, assassinations, terror, that's part of everyday life in Balochistan.
Looking at its location, as part of Pakistan, bordering Afghanistan and Iran, you may think, well, no surprise, dangerous place. But apart from being a dangerous place, Balochistan is of big geopolitical importance, where major world powers have interests. And China, one of them. Balochistan is sitting at the crossroads of oil and gas pipelines coming from Central Asia, Iran, and elsewhere. The Iran-Pakistan pipeline, the Turkmenistan-Afghanistan, Pakistan-India pipeline, not to mention that Balochistan itself has its energy resources. Besides, its water port, and it's right here, is the access point of Chinese commercial shipping to the Indian Ocean and on to Africa.
But all the violence and instability there doesn't make it an easy place for business. Investigative journalist Eric Dreitzer tells me some world powers might be interested in keeping it that way.
First of all, we have various indigenous terrorist organizations that operate inside of Balochistan, the Baloch Liberation Army, Jandullah, the Baloch Republican Army, Lashkar-e-Taiba, just to name a few. Jandullah is an organization that for decades has been focused on destabilization of Iran. Now, the confluence of these various terrorist organizations, of course, is not coincidental. This has a direct relation to the interests of the United States and the Western powers vis-a-vis blocking the Chinese, destabilizing Pakistan, and part of waging their covert war against Iran in hopes of not just encircling that country, but to collapse it from outside.
The U.S. government denies having any connection with Jandullah and Baloch terrorist organizations. Although CIA memos leaked recently say the Israeli Mossad recruited Jandullah members, quote, under the nose of U.S. intelligence officers, end of quote. As far as other terrorist groups, like the Baloch Liberation Front, there are a few people in U.S. Congress who expressed readiness to support the separation of Balochistan from Pakistan, like Dana Rohrabacher from the House of Representatives Committee on Foreign Affairs.
Anything that's coming up right now that the Pakistanis don't like about our attitude is being caused by actions taken by their government.
As far as who could benefit from instability in Balochistan, most experts say it's extremists of all kinds.
Mainly Al-Qaeda and its affiliates, and as well as the Taliban. They certainly have an interest in maintaining instability.
But some also see Balochistan as a key square on the geopolitical chessboard.
The United States knows they cannot compete with China economically or industrially, so they have to stunt China's development through these various subversive tactics. They're willing to engage with various terrorist networks that they've had for many, many years, if not decades, in order to try to make the Chinese stall in their economic development.
So according to you, pipe wars are real, and creating instability is one of the instruments to gain advantage. But wouldn't it backfire? The terror, violence, instability?
Could it backfire in terms of terrorist reciprocation against the United States? This is entirely possible, but that didn't prevent the United States in the late 1970s from financing and supporting the Mujahideen against the Soviets.
Allegations that some global powers may be stoking violence in a place like Balochistan for their geopolitical interests are quite disturbing and raises the question whether pipeline wars are a reality. In Washington, I'm Gainetcha Chikan.